here I have a 500 watt power supply. Over the last year, I've built over 15 tower computers, and this was the first time one was ever returned. Clients said the computer would abruptly power off. There wasn't any indications or warnings. It was connected to a UPS. There was no blue screens, there were no warnings, nothing. It will just straight up lose power, black screen, completely dead. After doing multiple tests, I came to the conclusion that it was the power supply that was defective. How did I arrive to this conclusion? At first I said, let me change out the power switch, because sometimes if the power switch is sticking, it can cause your computer to abruptly shut down. So I changed it out with a standalone switch instead. One like this. So it connects directly onto the motherboard and you use this clicker here to turn on your computer. That did not work. It still abruptly shut down. The next thing I decided to test is the memory. When you have faulty RAM, it can cause a computer to suddenly restart or even lose power. It depends. I ran a memory test using Windows plus R and then entered this command here, and then the test began. What I noticed is there was this strange sound coming from the tower computer. It sounded like something was starting up and shutting down. I looked at all of the fans because it sounded like a fan noise. Each of those tower computers that I built has four fans. Each fan functioning properly, there was no issues with it. After determining that none of the fans were their problem, next suspect would be the power supply fan. So I took a flashlight and looked into the computer and saw that the power supply fan was spinning up and then stopping. And that is where the strange sound was coming from. After determining that the fan in the power supply was faulty, I canceled the memory test. Running a faulty power supply can cause damages to your components like your memory, motherboard, CPU, and we do not want that. I canceled that test immediately. I took the power supply out of the tower computer. That brings me to my next device. How this power supply tester works is you connect as much of the power supply to the tester and then simply press this on button. It will then indicate if there's any issues with your power supply. For example, if your power supply tests good, there will be no alarms, no beeping, no warnings. But if something is wrong, you will know. Connecting the 24-pin, it does require some force, CPU, PCIe, Molex. Now that all of my power supply cables are connected to my power supply tester, I will now power on this. Just a little heads up, the alarm, it is very loud. It sounds like a smoke detector alarm going off. Be aware. Okay, I stopped it. That alarm clearly indicates that your power supply is defective. Additionally, on the screen, it would have indicated the code LL, which means your power supply is testing low voltage. My reading was under 12 volts. It shows that this power supply is defective. So if your tower computer is experiencing similar power issues as mentioned in this video, you can consider testing your power supply. This power supply tester cost me less than 20 US. I've had it for over 10 years. It is a very useful device to add to your toolbox.